Well, the annual parade of frocks and fillies once again turned out in force at the world's biggest picnic race meeting. Oakbank racegoers now making the journey home after a day filled with festivities. Hayley Canoll is there. She joins us live. Hayley.
Well, Beck, the final race has just been run and won, and Oakbank is over for another year. The crowds are slowly starting to trickle out through the gates, but traffic hasn't been too bad at this stage. Now, that could be because crowd numbers have been a little smaller than what we would normally see on an Easter Monday, but those who did take a punt on today's weather odds seem to have backed a winner. For the Oakbank faithful, comfort is a serious business.
We want to be comfy. We live here, so we've got to have the best setup on track. It's hometown.
We just embrace it and we love it. We've been coming since we were young.
The group of locals, the first through the gate, getting in line at 11:30 yesterday morning.
We only see one horse race for the day, but we're not here for that anyway.
Clearly too many distractions.
The Sherpas and fine friends and frocking up. See, I've got a fascinator.
Hats, the order of the day, some more stylish than others.
My grandma bought it for me.
Practicality of little concern.
Are you worried it might be a bit cold today?
Nah, it's good weather today. I'm actually quite hot.
Others take their sartorial choices far more seriously.
Because you're never quite sure what the weather's going to do, so you kind of have to have a backup.
For those who had an eye on the other fillies, everyone's got a winning tip.
To be honest, we just choose the horses with the prettiest names.
And winners most definitely winners.
It might be slightly down on last year, but until we get the numbers, I don't know.
The overcast weather putting off some punters. Despite one small hiccup, the controversial jump races are still crowd favourites.
That's the thrill of Oakbank.
Hayley Canoll, 10 News.